You know, Bernie Madoff might get some company in prison. There is now a report this morning in the New York Post exclusive report that family members have been talking with our next guest. They're worried they might end up in jail. Larry Levine, convicted white-collar criminal, is a prison consultant now joining us now from Los Angeles. Larry, so this piece comes out this morning in the Post, says that Shana Madoff, who is Peter Madoff's daughter, she was a compliance officer at the company, has called you specifically to say she is nervous about going to jail. Can you confirm that you've spoken with her, Larry?
Well, I had a woman call in. I'm going to lay it out to you the way I have to other people. Well, actually, you people are hearing it first. I had a woman call in. She was kind of wishy-washy. I was ready to hang up on her because I didn't have a lot of time. I'm real busy. I said, look, tell me about your case so I can see where we're going with this. And I finally pulled it out of her. She says, well, I'm tied to the Madoff case. I said, great. I says, well, what would you like me to do? And she really wanted to know. She didn't identify herself, okay? It wasn't the, it wasn't Ruth because she was too young, and it wasn't Bernie's granddaughter because it was too old. So I'm assuming it was Shana.
She's 38.
And she wanted to know how much.
Okay. All right, go ahead.
Well, you know, I could kind of tell. Okay. Anyway, so we talked really about prison time, how much time that someone would be looking at, and she is a lawyer, but I explained to her conspiracy laws that her, well, whoever it was, that Bernie was done. Bernie's never getting out, and that what she really needed to do was cut a deal to save herself with the U.S. attorney because it wouldn't impact Bernie's sentence at all. He's never getting out. She needed to look out for her own interests.
All right, somebody calls you up.
That's what we talked about.
Somebody calls up and says, I'm afraid I'm going to be going to prison. You're prison 101 or whatever you want to call it.
Fedtime 101.
What do you say to them, and what's their number one concern? Is it claustrophobia?
Their number one concern is, are they going to be assaulted? Are they going to be raped? Are they going to get out alive? And I teach them etiquette. How to deal with other prisoners, how to deal with the staff, how to show the proper amount of respect. I teach them basically just to get through their sentence without getting into a wreck. And I let them know that I'm there in the background. If they have a problem, their family members can get a hold of me. It's not really the inmates they have to worry about. It's the staff. And a woman going into federal prison faces more challenges than a man.
Okay.
If you take the incident on Tallahassee, Florida, a few years back, you had male Bureau of Prison staff members that were having sex with female inmates, and there was a shootout between the Justice Department and the Bureau of Prisons. But I teach the people how to survive, what they need to know.
Larry, so let's go back here, just for, if you don't mind, to the issue of Shana Madoff for a second. So she never said her name to you, but just said she was part of the Madoff group. Did a man call you from the Madoff family as well, or somebody connected to Madoff?
Yeah, this was right about the time that Bernie went into custody. I had a gentleman call me, and he was asking questions at all. He never said that he was Bernie's son. He didn't identify himself by name, but he started to say, my father, and then he cut himself off, and I deduced it. I was thinking, well, okay, I know who this guy is, but I didn't, like, let him know that I knew. We just talked about different aspects of what my program could do to help him out.
So you're not helping either of these individuals that has called you thus far. You're just, but these conversations have occurred by phone.
They have occurred, and it's exploratory. And I heard back from the reporter from the New York Post about an hour ago, and apparently Shana Madoff's reps have gotten a hold of the New York Post, and they're denying the fact that they ever even called me.
Okay.
And I have no way of knowing who actually called, but it was a woman that inferred certain things, and it leads me to believe that it is Shana Madoff. Although, am I 100% sure? No. But the New York Post is the one that called me to begin with. I don't let out the names of my clients.
Okay.
It's all confidential, and I was real surprised when they called me, and I asked them, well, how do you know?
Larry Levine, you've been very clear in giving us the facts as you know them, and we certainly appreciate it. Interesting story, Larry, and you've got an interesting perspective on the Madoff case in general in your business. But we thank you for coming on Fox Business, sir.
You know, I just love